Hey guys, how's it going? So I just wanted to do yet another update and talk about this being recorded on October 30th, 2013. So the Wednesday, which I generally refer to as Hump Day, the concept Hump Day really hasn't meant much to me in the recent past. I mean, it certainly kind of meant kind of something when I used to be a canvasser. But unless you have a regular works, you know, Monday to Friday, 9 to 5 kind of schedule, Hump Day really doesn't mean much to anyone. I think it really applies to students, you know, kids who go to school, people who have that regular 9 to 5 Monday to Friday schedule, which I do have now. And so Hump Day means a big deal. Like, I wake up on Wednesday just being like, oh God, I just hate the universe. I hate everyone. I don't want to wake up. Let me go back to sleep. But I can't. I have to take the 50-minute bus ride to my internship. I have to do it, because otherwise it's just, you know, I have no excuse other than the fact that I don't want to go. I want to sleep a little bit more. But if I do that, I'll probably end up not going at all, because that's how human psyche works. Sometimes. I don't know. Anyway, go there, and I just start the morning just dreading everything, you know? Don't want to talk to anyone, even though I have to, because it's social work major, you know, people work is social work. That's what it is, working with people. And in my case, working with ninth graders in a high school. But eventually, you know, it starts to wear off. I like to say this, I once said this to my supervisor, you know, I just begin most mornings just so dreading the day. You know, I wake up tired, groggy. I think groggy was the word I used. I'm just groggy in the morning, not a morning person. But I usually almost always end my days just fulfilled, satisfied, and I feel like accomplished. I accomplished a lot of things. And that's especially true on a Wednesday. My typical Wednesday so far, my experience has been a very productive Wednesdays. Right now, I have 4 students on my caseload, and that's as big as it's going to be as an intern. 4 students, that's the maximum size of my caseload. Just by a week ago, last week, my caseload was 3 students. Now I have 4 clients on my caseload, and they're all very interesting, challenging cases. I mean, human beings are complex beings. Even if you think you have a case that's easy, that's most likely not going to be the case as you learn more and more about the person. These are very 4 complex cases, which is as I would have expected. In some ways they're really challenging, in some ways there are a lot of easy things about it, working with these students. But anyways, 4 cases I have scheduled. On Wednesdays I really have only scheduled one to meet with one student for individual counseling or individual therapy session. That's what I provide, you know. I talk with these kids and try to help them out, provide emotional and mental support. I generally only meet with one, but last week I met with 2 because one of the kids was absent on the other day I was supposed to meet him, so this was a makeup session. And today, I had 2 sessions just because another student has been added to my caseload, so now I have 4 clients on my caseload. And so the 4th client I met today for a session for the first time ever. I've talked to him before, but today is the day I actually met him for a therapy session. So there's that. I did 2 individual counseling sessions, just like last week. And on Wednesdays, I co-facilitate this group with my supervisor. And this group is composed of 12 students. 1 dropped out. But these 11 students, they have leadership potential, or they were judged to have leadership potential. And I agree with that, actually, the 11 students who were chosen for this. And we train them to be peer mediators. So in case a conflict happens among, let's say, a pair of students in the school, maybe one student got angry at the other student and pushed another student, and the fight happened, and teacher stopped it, but there's still like underlying tension between the two, then we do what is called a peer mediation, which is like a quote-unquote definition, you know, is a process where 2 or more people come together to form an agreement that they feel comfortable with. That's peer mediation in a nutshell. But who is facilitating it? Other students. that were training as peer mediators. And it's an amazing group. It's an amazing experience for me, having to kind of facilitate this group. It's like training many social workers. It's an amazing experience to me. But it's, you know, we plan things, we plan workshops and how to educate this group of kids and also how to make this group as fun as possible for them, because we are taking them out of their lunch period to train them for this. So, you know, and I think that may have been a big reason why one of the kids dropped out of this group, because he wanted to enjoy lunch with his friends. I'm not sure. The only thing he actually told us was he doesn't like being in it anymore. He doesn't want to be in it anymore. And, you know, it's a voluntary group. We're not going to force him to be in this group. So, you know. But there's that. Also, another big taxing thing for me on Wednesday, but really important, is I meet with my supervisor on Wednesday for the regular supervision session. And that's when we kind of discuss how things are going, the challenges I'm having. We discuss cases, the challenges of the case, what can be improved on, what needs to be worked on, and process recordings, administrative stuff, just supervision session. It can get pretty intense. I find my supervisor to be very insightful. There's a lot of things that she tells me that I find really useful, and I use it in the next therapy sessions with my students or next in another group I run. And it has been very helpful to me so far, applying a lot of the things that my supervisor has recommended or advised to me. And then of course there's a whole gamut of paperwork to do and things like that. But just those things alone make Wednesdays super productive and definitely like a hump day to me. I come home, on my way home, I'm just like, oh man, that was quite a day. Like, I did a lot as a social work intern. So Wednesdays is definitely like the epitome of one of those days where I start groggy and then I end the day just kind of like feeling like I accomplished a great deal. And usually it's not a bad, I don't think I've ended a Wednesday really badly. There's always a lot to think about because it's the middle of the week. You know, there's still plans to be made to end the week. And I'm looking forward to the weekend when I have a bit more free time. When I come home on Wednesday, there's still so much stuff to do, especially considering the fact that I'm a graduate student. This week in particular is pretty crazy. I have two midterms due. One midterm is due this Saturday. I don't think it's going to be that challenging. It's a midterm I have to do for human behavior class, so it's very largely focused on like psychodynamic theory, object relations, things like that. And we get a case study. We look at this vignette of a client, of a potential client, and then we kind of try to figure out where that client is, you know, psychodynamically speaking, which I think is an interesting exercise, and I think the paper would end up interesting. The other midterm due is for my policy class. This one is much more challenging. My professor is also currently a defense attorney, but he used to be a mental health director, so he used to, you know, be a social worker or director of a mental health facility. And it makes me utilize like New York Times articles that I pick out to answer some of his questions and make like citations and whatnot. That midterm, it's supposed to be about 10 pages long, is due this Tuesday, this upcoming Tuesday. That's going to be a lot of work. So after I record this video, I'm going to continue working on that stuff. But that's really my Wednesdays now. It's just really like so much stuff goes on a Wednesday. I come back home and it's just like I still have stuff to do. And I can't wait till it's Sunday. Sunday is really the only free day I have now. Saturdays I go to college, I have classes back to back. I don't get home until like 6 o'clock or 7 o'clock at night. But Sunday, recently, like 2 weeks ago or 3 weeks ago and 4 weeks ago, you know, I went to church just because, you know, to satisfy my parents' desire for me to go to church, even though they're 1,000 miles away from me. But like, Sunday is the only free day I can have. Like, now I'm just like, I didn't go last week. I didn't go the week before. And I don't really think I'll continue going. Just, I like the people at the church, but, you know my stance on that. Church, I want a free day, and that's what I get Sundays for that. But anyway, that's my update for today. If you guys enjoyed hearing me blabber on about my life.